Hello students, I'm Anita Abraham, Associate Professor of English. Welcome to the English classroom. This is video number 26. Today's English lesson is from semester 3 of the General English curriculum prescribed by Osmania University for students of BA, BCom, BSc and BBA. Today's topic is titled Media Reports. If you like my video, please subscribe and press the bell icon so that you get notified of subsequent videos. Let's get started. Media reports. Media can broadly be categorized into the print media, electronic media, and digital media. Print media is also known as static media. It refers to newspapers, news magazines. While electronic media, also sometimes called as live media, comprises of the radio and the television. Digital media, also known as new media, includes internet, the World Wide Web, the WWW, and the smartphones, etc. Writing reports for media differs from writing general reports or essays. Essays and reports begin with an introduction and progresses in a chronological or sequential order towards a conclusion. Media reports, on the other hand, in contrast, do just the opposite. They begin with the conclusion and discloses the details gradually. To grab the attention of the reader or the viewer, the media reports use the most essential element of the report first, followed by details and supporting information in order of diminishing or lesser importance. The method followed in writing media reports or presenting media reports is called the inverted pyramid style of writing, because it turns the conventional structure of writing upside down by starting with the conclusion. Usually you have the introduction, the body and the conclusion. But in media writing, the pyramid gets inverted. All right, the conventional structure of introduction, body and conclusion is inverted, turned upside down, and you begin with the conclusion, and then, you know, the information is presented as it goes lesser in importance. It's also sometimes referred to as front loading style, because it gives the most important information first and directly. Okay, so there is no quoting it, because it is for media reporting, time is very important. So the most important thing is loaded up front. Okay, presented immediately. Let's look at this graphic description of the descending order, okay, of the inverted pyramid of the media report, and how it is in a descending order. Okay, so what comes first is the climax, the summary lead, the most important information, the newest information, the who, the what, the why, the where, and when. Okay, the 5 W's of news or media reporting. Okay, and then it moves on to the body facts in the descending order of importance. So the more important details will come in the beginning, and then it goes down in that sequence, and it towards the end, towards the lower half of the inverted pyramid, you have least important details, or some background information will be given to support or scaffold the news item. So this is very important for us to understand in writing media reports, whether it is for the print media or whether it is for the digital media. Okay, it is very or the electronic media, we follow this inverted pyramid of writing reports. Now, how to let's look at how to write a media report. A good media report is one that catches the attention of the reader quickly or the viewer quickly and is able to convince the reader or viewer to read through the story or hear the listen to the story. Remember, today's reader or listener of the report has many alternate sources of information and they have no patience for with a badly written or badly presented report. So it is very important that, you know, catching the attention of the reader or the listener is very important, because see, like, we have print media, we have electronic media, and we have the new media, which is the digital media, and the same news or media reports are available on all these platforms. So if something is not presented well, the viewer has alternate sources to go and get it from, and then everybody is giving, you know, there are so many channels, so many newspapers, so many YouTube channels or whatever presenting the same information. So you will just go and look at the listener or the reader will go to a source for information which is well written and well presented. So to grab the attention and retain the interest of the reader and the listener, here are some techniques. So while writing a media report for whatever medium, whether it is the print media, the electric media or the digital media, we must keep these things in mind. What is the first important thing? Compose a catchy headline, because the headline grabs the attention. The headline is what catches the attention of the reader or the listener first. So to make it crisp and lively, use vivid language and verbs, active verbs, okay? The headline should convey the basic idea of the story in a single line. Therefore, it may be easier and prudent to write the headline after writing the report. So whether you're writing for the print media or whether it is for the electronic or digital media where you will be presenting, essentially, first it must be written down. So write the report and then go for the headline so it is catchy. All right. The first paragraph, it's called the lead paragraph. Okay, so look at all the technical vocabulary. Remember, we did technical vocabulary. Look at all the technical vocabulary that goes into writing for media. Okay, the first paragraph is called the lead paragraph. It forms the base of the inverted pyramid, okay, and contains essential information. In journalism, essential information refers to the 5 W's: who, what, when, where, why. Okay, so these are the 5 W's. The lead paragraph should convey to the reader or the listener the essential facts about who did it, what, when, where, why. Facts and figures may be quoted in the lead paragraph, but not as dry statistics. It should be integrated into the story and narrated in an interesting manner. So the headline is important. It should be catchy, and the lead paragraph should be is the base of the inverted pyramid, and it should contain the 5 W's, okay, and it should be supported by data, statistics, integrated very well into the narrative. The remaining paragraphs contain the additional details, background information, quotes by sources, interview bites, or what, you know, the arrangement of information follows the inverted pyramid structure, with most important and newest information at the top and the least important and oldest information at the bottom. So we must remember the inverted pyramid as the structure which should be followed in media report in descending order, right? Okay, then moving on, double check the report for accuracy of facts, verify dates, spelling of narrators, designation, proofread the copy of spelling and grammar errors and illegancies. Okay, so what it the post writing stage continues. you where you revise, you proofread, so that you know it is a well-written what do you call report, and you have spelled for grammar, you have spelled for you have checked for grammar, you have checked for spellings, and you have made sure that you know there is no error with names, designations, locations, facts, figures. Otherwise, you know, paper, if it's print media or your magazine, or if it's the news, if it's the electronic media, your channel, or if it's the digital platform, could lose its credibility if you don't present it well. Now let's look at an example. Let's look at the inverted style used in the following excerpt. So I've bought a small sample for you so that you understand how this inverted pyramid works in media report, writing media reports. Okay, for all the three print, electronic, and digital platform. Look at the title here. Garment hospitals to get a hygiene makeover. It is updated May 8, 2017, and even the time, IST, Indian Standard Time, is also given. Okay, look at this. Multicolored bed sheets to be distributed today. So one would think government hospitals, multicolored bed sheets, it catches the attention immediately. And then there is it's a hygiene makeover, but the multicolored bed sheet is going to catch the readers or the listeners' attention. Beds in wards of government hospitals across Telangana will sport multicolored bed sheets from Monday. So that's, you know, the lead paragraph, you see what's coming. Okay, calling it a pink day because it will essentially be a distribution of pink bed sheets in a big way. The government will replace the existing bed sheets in hospitals with pink, white, dark blue, and sky blue bed sheets. The blue bed sheets were for smaller number of beds, while the existing beds already had white bed sheets. Ministers, MPs, MLAs, MLCs will distribute as many as 51,998 bed sheets on a single day, a government release said. The new bed sheets will include 19,974 pink and white ones, 6,025 each dark and sky blue for 10,735. Okay, so 737. So do you see what has happened here? Let's look at it once again. So it is hygiene makeover in government hospitals, multicolored bed sheets, and the number of bed sheets, and it's called the pink day, and the number of bed sheets, and who will be coming there to distribute, the total number is given, and then even the breakdown is given. All right, now let's look at some more guidelines to write media reports. This applies for print, electronic, and digital media. Use clear and simple language, shorter words, buy rather than purchase, and active verbs. We watched the match instead of the match was watched by us. Okay, so be very careful how you present it. Okay, and then avoid jargons and slangs and complex sentence structures. Try to include only one idea in a sentence. Okay, so it should be easy to the ear and the eye. Make each paragraph present only one idea or concept, like you had in the essay and in the report writing. Front load each paragraph, that is, start each paragraph with the main idea or the conclusion of the paragraph. Okay, so front loading is very important. That's again a technical term, like we saw, like lead paragraph. Okay, so the important idea should come there. Okay, and then the next thing is be direct. Make your point first and then explain. Okay, because if your lead or your the first sentence is interesting, then only people will read the rest of it. Or if they listen to it and it's interesting, the first sentence, what you are presenting, then only they will want to listen to the rest of it. So the beginning of your news or report or your media report should be very interesting. The front loading or the direct approach may be considered inelegant, blunt, even rude, perhaps in other kind of writing, you know, when you are so, you know, direct, you just go to the point without, you know, trying to cover it up or gloss it or, you know, wrap it up. You're just being direct, hard hitting. This front loading or direct approach may look rude in essay writing, letter writing, okay, or even in a business report, but not in media report, because the idea of media report, whether it is print media, electronic media or digital media, is to grab the attention of the reader. So it is very important that you front load or go for the front direct approach and, you know, present the important facts first and then go on to explaining. But this is the front loading or direct approach is the preferred style of media report, because their target reader or listener is one who wants to grasp the information quickly and easily. Okay, so the reader or the listener will decide whether they want to read the rest of the report or hear the rest of the report based on, you know, how interesting your presentation is in the beginning. So it's very important that you make your point first and then explain. And then the next important thing would be to give details, but only as much as is required. Don't drag it and, you know, don't make it uninteresting. Keep it crisp, concise and interesting. I have the reader and the listener wanting more. Okay, they should look forward to the next part of the presentation or what is going to come next about this particular item. Always remember, the reader or the listener is under no obligation to read or listen to the report. You have to catch the reader's attention and or the listener's attention and make sure that you don't lose it. Okay, so that's very important, students. In a media report, whether it is the print media, electronic media or digital media, the reader or the listener is under no obligation to listen or read your report. So it becomes important that you follow the steps of the writing the report very, very carefully, because you need to grab the attention of the reader and the listener and keep it. So I'll leave you again with the inverted pyramid, which is the structure for media writing. So in the beginning, you must have the climax, the summary, the lead, the most important point, the latest information, and you must follow the five W's. Who, what, when, where, why. You must front load it. Okay, direct approach. Your lead paragraph must contain all this. Okay, in part, the base of the inverted pyramid. Then, in descending order, you go to the body where the facts are presented in descending order and give other important details. Only that which will keep or retain the attention of your reader and listener. And in towards the end of it, you will conclude with important details and provide some background information, and also leave the reader or the listener asking for more. I hope, students, you understood how to go about writing a media report and how it is very different from the kind of writing that we have learned so far, be it essay writing or business report. So this letter writing. So the media reports are written in an entirely different format. So do practice writing media reports, and also while you're reading newspapers, news magazines, or listening to the news on the TV or the radio, or on the digital platform, whether it is your YouTube or whatever you watch on news, on see how the reports are presented and how they follow the inverted pyramid structure. Thank you so much. Stay safe and take care.